Okay, I thought you guys might want to have a look around. I've got everything unboxed and unpackaged. This is a Kaser SFC75. I thought you might like to have a look inside of it. It's got the sound deadening insulation inside, so it runs very quiet. Motor, coupling, pump, receiver, and then this box in here is a refrigerated air dryer. So it's got a dryer built into it. We'll walk around the other side and look at that. So that's all on one side of the service cabinet. Let's look at the electrical end of it. Two big vents there. Hooked up to a couple cooling fans. Big VFD. That is the big Siemens VFD, quite large. Shielded outputs. And some other smaller controls. So they got the touchpad. Pretty nice. And this is the dryer end of it. And it's the radiator for the refrigerator air dryer. And another service door. Again with the sound insulation here. Nice. That is a condensate filter and evaporator. So all your condensate out of the compressor and then all the little dryers goes in there. And that's a condensate manifold that gets bolted to the wall and it gravity feeds down to this unit here. This is a regenerative desiccant dryer. So those two big tanks have desiccant in them. And one side can be regenerating while the other side is cleaning. Nice unit, already on a floor stand. Just drop it on the floor, bolt it down, done. Nice. And last up is our receiver tank. It was all under plastic before, but this is a monster. Get the idea of the magnitude of that. So fairly large. It's got the big 150-pound flanges in and out. Inspection door. And then, of course, we do have an auto drain for that tank. That's the float type auto drain. It goes underneath that tank. It works like a toilet float. It's got a little pilot valve on top, and it. Anytime there's water gets in it, it just burps it out. Pretty simple. And all those drains, this drain from the receiver tank, and all these are auto drain. These are all the float type. This one here is on a timer. So that's the first, that's the main stage, and then there's the other little stages. And those all get tubing over to that manifold. And then that manifold drains into the cleaner and evaporator for the condensate. Okay, so next up we're going to be getting the stuff in place and getting ready to start piping it. Okay, so we got the compressor off the skid. And the thing about these is the way they set them down on the skids, they within the cabinet they conceal some lag bolts. There's lag bolts going through the unit down into the skid inside the cabinet. If you don't know where they are, you can't get the thing separated. After the lag bolts are out, it's got kind of some rubber feet, big rubber feet on the bottom, so you can get under it with a forklift pretty easy, but these are hanging down into the skid, so you have to put some blocks in between and do some monkey motion and you'll get it done. So compressor drops in pretty easy. Next up is the tank. The tank actually won't stand up inside the building. We have to take it outside of the building, stand it up, and then bring it in vertically. All right, so that's tank. Let's get outside and get this thing picked up. We got some nice picking eyes right here, welded to the tank. So we just checked the bill of lading, and it's 1,197 kilograms. I think it comes out to under 3,000 pounds. So.
Here it is, easier to move.
Right? I was surprised.
When I say watch out, that means be ready to run.
Run for your life.
Alright. All right. We're gonna roll this fucking pig out of here. A little dust on it, but outside of that, as long as you didn't scratch the shit out of it.
I'm trying to do this.
What?
Just like this.
Yeah.